Network adapters are needed to connect to the network, but what happens if they don't? Let's talk to Wes at the bench, find out why. Hey, Wes, good to see you.
Hey, good to see you too, Zach.
And we're both kind of wearing gray, huh?
I know. I guess I got the memo.
We did. We must have got the same memo.
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
From the network?
Maybe. I see what you did there.
That leads me into my topic of the day is network adapters,
sure.
Configuration. Network adapters, what I know of it is network adapters help us to connect to a network.
That's right.
Is that right?
Yeah. Okay. Basic functionality, sure.
So, other than the obvious answer, which I'm sure you're going to give me anyway, how do we know if there might be some issues with it?
So I want you to give me the obvious answer.
You can't connect to that network.
It is. It really is. And you know, joking aside, it's not always that easy.
No.
Sometimes it really is that easy. If a network adapter is failing, you just don't have connectivity to the network. But, you know, even saying the network adapter is failing, sometimes it isn't really so much the truth, you know, because you could get intermittent issues where you notice when you stretch out and you kick a wire maybe under your desk. And in this context, we're really talking about wired connections, you know, or maybe you move your desk chair, mm-hmm. you know, your computer desk chair, you roll it back in a certain way, and then you see you lose connectivity. So it doesn't necessarily have to be that all network connectivity is lost. A lot of times it is, but sometimes you have those occasions where you have what's known as just intermittent network connectivity.
So intermittent, like fluctuating or fluttering, or maybe it's slow to connect, that sort of thing? Or
It could be slow, absolutely. That could be one thing, but it could be one of those things where you're getting a connection and maybe you notice on your desktop it says not connected.
Right,
or limited connection.
I've seen that.
Or it comes back, and then it goes away for a few minutes, and that's a telltale sign that's intermittent connectivity. A lot of times we don't see that on wireless networks.
Mm-hmm.
There are sometimes, again, can never say never. A lot of times you see that in wireless networks, but there are occasions that it might creep up into wired networks too.
Because we're talking about the wired networks.
That's right.
Right now. So what causes that? What causes this? Fluctuation, fluttering, or non-connectivity.
Non-connectivity. Okay, so we'll leave intermittent connectivity till the end. Let's address just no connectivity right away. All right. So no connectivity. This could be a couple of things. As you can see, I'm on a laptop here. One of the things that you'll see in your PCs is the ability to disable the network adapter,
and that could be
a simple setting. I just want you to think about a light switch, right? You have lights in your house, you know, and you turn the light switch off. Obviously, it turns the lights off, and you can't see, right?
We don't have lights in our home yet.
Okay, you're still working on that. All right. Still working on candlelight. All right. So maybe not so good for your house.
But if
you think about the light switch, there's nothing wrong with the lights. There's nothing wrong with the switch. It's just been turned off. And that can happen. A lot of times that can happen on keyboards more than it does your standard workstation and PCs because you have some kind of keyboard shortcut that disables the network adapter across the function keys of your keyboard. But you can also disable it in the settings. So sometimes it can just be simple. It can be that simple that it's just a disabled network adapter. Other things that could cause the network adapter to fail to connect to the network, and again, I don't want to say that we just say right away it's a network failure or a network adapter failure, could be the fact that maybe you have recently updated drivers, and if you update drivers...
Oh, sure, that would make sense.
You know, so think about what the driver does, and we've talked about this before. Driver is just a piece of software that allows us to communicate, and more importantly, our operating system to communicate with the hardware. And if your network adapter, like you rightly observed, is managing network connections, if that driver isn't appropriate, then what ends up happening is you could lose communications that way. So that's a couple of things, right? You could have had a disabled network adapter. You could have driver issues. Other things that can happen, too, you can see like slower performance. Slower performance can be a setting mismatch that we can show you here in a bit. It could be the configuration of your... network adapter in and of itself. It could be a software setting where you have a certain few settings that you have to configure to make sure that your computer can connect to the network on how it receives a network address or an IP address, as they call it. And if that's configured wrong, you could have issues there too. The other thing it might be too, it might have absolutely nothing to do with your computer. It could be the connectivity device that you have plugged into.
The device itself.
That's right. Yes, sir. Absolutely. So your home router or something.
Routers or the modems.
Because your home routers are typically configured that when you plug into them, your computer says, hey, I need this network address, and it's called an IP address, to be able to communicate with the network. Can you give me one? Well, if it's snoozing and it doesn't give you that address, then you don't have connectivity.
Or an older one, too, for that matter.
It might be an older one, and an older one is where you can get some of these properties of your network adapter that are just mismatched. They call it a duplex mismatch, and we can definitely talk about that. The final one that could happen is, especially when it comes to things like intermittent communications on a wired network, mm-hmm. it could be the fact that the network adapter itself the cable itself is bad.
Well, I was going to ask you about cables.
Sure.
It could be the cables, right?
Sure. Do you got pets at the house?
I have a cat that likes to chew on things.
There you go. Yeah,
it has happened.
Okay, yeah.
Right through the casing, right into the wires.
Yep,
right
absolutely. And what happens sometimes there is there's just a little breaking of the wire, mm-hmm. so you're getting a little bit of communication, yeah. but if you, like I said, if you stretch out or you move your chair, mm-hmm. You notice that the network drops off. It could be the fact that maybe the cat chewed through the sleeving a little bit too much.
The cat was looking at me the whole time like,
yeah. We know those cats' attitudes. Another thing, too, it could be the fact that the cable's damaged in a way that around the little connector part that goes into the ports on your computer.
Right.
That could be slightly cracked. It could be stretched out if you happen to move the computer and you can't stretch wires. You can, but they won't work too well after that. And what happens is if you separate the little plug, which is called an RJ45 jack, just called it an Ethernet jack, from the sleeving of the cable and there's exposed wire, what you've done is you've created an antenna. And that means that EMI, electromagnetic interference, is going to get into that cable, and you could start to see that the performance just is really horrible.
That makes a lot of sense.
Sure.
So now at this point, mm-hmm. how do we fix all this? What are the solutions?
Okay, so let's double back on the network adapter being disabled. So I'm here on a Windows 10 machine, and one of the things that you're going to notice is that down here at the bottom, I don't have network connectivity. You'll notice that I don't have network access.
Right.
All right, well, with not having the network access here, I could try to figure out, hey, what potentially is the issue? It could be the fact that the cable's just not plugged in. Mm-hmm. It could be that. It could be the fact that you have disabled the network adapter. So for instance, if you look at Ethernet properties of Ethernet here, all right, one of the things that you could potentially have is you could potentially have it disabled and completely turned off. So for instance, if this happens a lot, this could happen in the old control panel. So I went down to the instant search field and I chose control panel here. And when we launched that up, in control panel, you'll see network and internet.
Right.
And inside the network and sharing center, you're going to notice that if we choose on the left-hand side adapter settings, that we've got a series of network cables here, network connections here.
Yeah.
And the one that I'm looking at really is this Ethernet 0. And notice how it's got this option to potentially disable it.
Yeah.
All right, well, that can happen on your workstations too. Now, if we look at it, it's disabled. Well, here's the problem. Being disabled, it's no longer going to allow me to communicate. There's nothing wrong with the cable. No. There's nothing wrong with the network adapter. And there might not be anything wrong with the settings on your home router. So you'd have to come in here, and then looking here, you would just basically re-enable it. That is one thing, and that is something that I have seen before where, you know, your cable, everything else is okay. Mm-hmm. But starting with the network adapter, what we can see here is that it isn't connected because it's disabled.
Now, could that happen just basically automatically or by itself? I mean, without you doing anything, just something happened and
it disabled itself? Not really. One of the things that I've noticed...
So it's a pilot error.
It could be an operation, you know, the operator error.
Operator.
Never say never, right? So we definitely have to worry about that. Now, the other thing, too, that we want to make sure that we are aware of, too, is that we want to make sure of the properties of the network adapter here, too. And one of the things that I mentioned was the network address. If I look in here to my network adapter is connected via USB. Mm-hmm. This one right here is the interface that's connected. If I right-click and I choose properties, all right, these are the properties of the network adapter. And if we scroll down here, one of the things that we'll see here is that there is this Internet Protocol version 4. Mm. And if I select that, you're going to notice that properties shows up. Mm-hmm. And if I choose properties, one of the things that I can see is that it's telling me to obtain an IP address automatically. And that's where I said when you plug your computer into the home network or whatever the connectivity device is, it should say, hey, I need an IP address. I need this network address.
So enabling that's best practice?
It is on a home network. It really depends.
Right.
Yeah. Some people want to. My clients, mm-hmm. I would absolutely say keep it obtained automatically.
Right.
But if you've got servers or other dedicated hardware on your networks, you might want to statically configure this. And if we look, that's where you could have a problem too. If any one of these settings in here are mismanaged and they don't match what you have on your network, then you're not going to be able to connect either.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I typically just leave this to obtain an IP address automatically. And then DNS is just the way we resolve names out there on the internet. And I make sure that that is chosen as well. And then we choose close. The way you can find out here real easy if you have an IP address is just to right click on it and you choose this status option. And when you choose the status option, notice it's telling me IPv6. I don't have any internet access. That's okay, because I'm not really using an IPv6 address
now,
so it's not bothering me. But this is the one, and this is why we looked at this one right here, the IPv4 connectivity.
Is IPv4, is that still the most common?
It is, because largely the internet is IPv4 based, but for the long time we've been switching over to IPv6.
Soon.
But they've been saying soon for 30 years now. So. But well, if we look at
relative,
that's right. If we look at details here, this is really what I want to see. And when I see details, notice I told you obtain an IP address automatically.
Right.
That's something called DHCP. That's the service that basically says, yeah, here's your IP address. I have one, and I can see that that is the setting. More importantly, I can see that it's handed me an address, and it's handed me a subnet mask, which helps me identify what network I'm on, and then also the default gateway, which is just where that's our connectivity device that's going to allow us to connect over to the internet. Now, once that's done, I'm going to close these down. We can actually test the connectivity now that we've made sure that the network adapter is enabled and that it does have an IP address by typing in CMD to the instant search field. That's the command prompt.
Right.
And you can run a simple test. You can run a ping. All right. Now, we can run a ping against our default gateway.
Right.
And if we can connect, if we get replies back like we're getting here, then that means I can at least connect internally to my home router or my home device, connectivity device, depending on what you're using.
Right.
But then we want to go a step farther. And if we want to test a little bit more, we can test something out there on the internet itself. So for instance, I can do something like this. And this just happens to be an IP address that I am doing the same thing, doing a ping. And then I'm going to do a 4.2.2.1. And this is a high-level DNS server that's run by Level 3, one of the major companies out there. And it's usually always online because it needs to be providing that service. And notice that it's responding back to me.
It is.
Now I know that I do have connectivity. Now, I will say, Zach, one of the other things that I mentioned is some of the settings on your network adapter, other than the IP address settings, is things like driver settings.
Yeah, and then drivers next,
right, and then there's something also that could happen called a duplex mismatch. And let me show you what I mean here. So if I go, if I right-click on our start button and I choose this device manager option, these are where all of the drivers are managed within your operating system. And if we look at network adapters, and if I was ever to expand this out and I was to see some kind of question mark or like a little exclamation point here, it would tell me that there's something wrong. I'm not having any issue here with the network adapter, but I could select the network adapter that I thought was having an issue, and I could right-click and I could choose properties, and I could see what the current status is, and we could also do some driver management too. So you'll see the driver tab right here, and that driver tab would give me details on the driver, and then we'd need to go out to the vendor's website and pull down the appropriate driver to make sure, or just inspect it and make sure that we have the appropriate driver. The other one is some of the advanced settings here on this tab, and one of the things that might happen is you might have a duplex mismatch within your networks, and that's under speed and duplex. It's typically set to auto negotiation, but if the auto negotiation doesn't happen and you're running in a different duplex than what the computer picks, you're going to notice the performance goes really bad. So
these
are some of the things just to keep in mind, you know, from the software side, that you could definitely check within your computer to verify that the network adapter is functioning, your settings are correct, and that at least from this standpoint, you don't have an issue, if you will, with those attributes.
So how do we fix the cat chewing on the cable situation?
All right,
let's
all right.
Address the cables.
So we don't let the cat chew on the cables.
No,
that'll be a hair.
I'll
tell you what, Zach, let me go ahead and I'm going to set this to the side. And if you could,
sure.
We've got a cable over here. All right, we'll bring that into the picture here. And give me that little device right there here. So if we take a look at here, what we got, we've got a known good cable.
Yeah.
All right, now, if I suspect that the cable that I have in my system is bad, right, this is the one that we're plugged in with, then what we could do is we could use one of these devices, and to test the cable, what we would do is we would plug one end of the cable into this side of this cable tester,
right,
and then we would find where the other side of the cable is in there, or is, and then we would attach that to the other side.
Right.
Now, you don't have to have this together, but for our demonstration purposes, and let me turn this the right way so we're actually reading it right side up. Okay. If I turn this on, one of the things that you're going to notice is that it's going to go, and you notice how these lights are going
it's
down one by one? Absolutely. Okay, so what that's letting me know, there are 8 conductors inside of this cable, these network cables, and it's letting me know that it's giving me consistency between each one of the conductors on each side of the cable. Right, so that's a way that you can test the cable and find out if there's an issue. Now, Zach, do you have one of these in your house?
I have several.
Oh, okay.
In every room, I have a cable tester.
I think your nose is growing.
It is. It's growing. And that's unfortunate, as we know.
Yeah, well, and I realize that people aren't just going to have one of these laying around. We have them laying around here, and I have one myself because I do have to test cables for people from time to time.
Right.
And certainly around here at ITProTV, I can't tell you how many thousands of feet of cables that they've run, and they make their own cables. So they have to test them regularly, which is why we have a few of these on our networks. However, don't fret. You don't have to go out and buy one of those. You know, I said that if we were if we were thinking that the cable that we were using here was bad, all right, easiest way you can do you could test whether the cable is to test everything that we tested before, and then take a known good cable and plug it in.
Right on.
If your connection is restored, then at this point you've eliminated everything else. The only thing left is the cable. It's a bad cable, and it's time to replace the cable.
Get a good cable.
That's right. So those are some of the things that you can do.
Wes, thank you very much.
Absolutely.